Let's take a look at our top selections. Dan Illman, Mike Beer, let's take a look at the field for Sunday's co-feature race at Santa Anita. It's the possibly perfect stakes for fillies and mares going a mile and a quarter on the turf. $75,000 is the purse, and the number three dog tag is your 9-5 morning line favorite. She's going to have to do it at this distance, but she's done it at this distance before. She won it last year going second off the layoff, stretching out from a mile to a mile and a quarter. She'll try to do it again this year.
I guess that's just another point in her favor, Dan. She might just be the best horse anyway, although I guess that could be debated. But she won this race last year, and it didn't look like she had any problem with the distance. She's a relatively short price on the line, but she's also way the horse to beat.
And one of her great assets is her tactical speed. As we take a look at the time form U.S. pace projector, dog tag expected to be forwardly placed in here. The number eight could show a little bit of speed as well. And I wouldn't be surprised if Trevor McCarthy has that one close to the pace. Ride for the cause, the number seven's tactical. Sat a good trip last time, likely to get another one here.
Yeah, I agree with that. She should get a fall into another good trip in this spot. Maybe, I guess you could just say the mile and a half was a little bit too much for her last time because she had no excuse.
Stepping up off a victory going a mile and an eighth is the number one Lady Noguez. And we're going to watch her most recent race against starter optional claiming competition. She got a solid pace to run at in this race, Mike. She storms down the stretch to win this one. 74 buyer speed figure, but she's still eligible for a non-winners of three life.
Yeah, she ran fine in this race. Probably a career best effort for this filly, who did have a pretty good pace to run at. I mean, I don't know, Dan, you look at her on paper and compare it to the other horses in the race, she's pretty hard to like.
Go Big Blue Nation seems to have improved slightly since stretching out to these longer distances for Preakness winning trainer Michael McCarthy, a winner at this distance two starts back. They ran her in the Santa Barbara last time going a mile and a half, and she was beaten by a couple of these. And to be honest, I just thought she ran around there. 5-2 on the morning line to me seems a bit light.
I agree with that. I wouldn't want her out of that last race. Listen, to be fair to her, she did run pretty well two starts back when she won. That Santa Barbara last time, we have the three horses coming out of that race. I just don't like that race that much. I don't necessarily think I want any of those horses coming out of there. And that, to me, just makes the favorite position that much stronger.
And here is Dog Tag's one and only start of 2021. This was the Grade 2 Royal Heroine, and she checked a little bit entering the far turn while down inside. She's still down inside. Now she's going to get a seam to run through, and she's going to finish up nicely against Charmaine's Mia, a mare that was on quite a roll at this time.
Yeah, she runs fine in here. She a pretty good finish here once she gets clear. She's going to run out of real estate, but that's no disgrace to Charmaine's Mia, who was 3-4 to 5 in this race, or 3-5 in that race, I think. That was her third graded stakes win in a row, and she just controlled the action the entire way around there. I thought Dog Tag ran fine, and again, you don't really have to worry about distance. To me, she's just such a clear-cut horse to beat in here.
Dinah Power, the 4, 50-1 on the morning line, deservedly so, eligible for a two life, and the only win came on synth.
Yeah, another horse who just, based on the races she's run so far, does not stack up with this field.
Neige Blanche won the Santa Barbara. That's the race that you mentioned that you didn't like very much going a mile and a half. Let's watch it right now. They turn into the stretch. Neige Blanche is on the outside, directly down towards the inside behind the pace setter as the two ride for the cause. And right in behind them is the number 6, Catch the Eye. Going to be a photo finish. Neige Blanche is just going to get the better for Ride for the Cause. You see Go Big Blue Nation moving into fourth. Didn't like the race. Of the four, I thought Catch the Eye was the horse maybe to watch out for because I didn't think she really had a clear run.
Yeah, that's probably true. Being down towards the inside there probably worked against her, worked against Catch the Eye. So we'll see if she can take a step forward. I don't know. Again, it's not a race that does a lot for me. I suppose in defense of Neige Blanche, who obviously her connections think pretty highly of her. I mean, they've run her in nothing but big races since she got over here. And they were finally rewarded with that win last time. But, it just wasn't the kind of effort that made me want to come right back to her in this race.
She was third in the Belmont Oaks last year. You're right. They've tried her in some very tough spots. Catch the Eyes, the number six. She's 15-1 on the morning line. Maybe stretching out to a mile and a half really helped her in that race. She was good enough to be third in the maybe last year, going a mile and an eighth. The problem is she's kind of an in and outer that rarely strings two good ones back to back.
Agreed with that. And, you know, you're also talking about a horse who, you know, while she's fine at a mile and an eighth, you know, they've tried longer distances with her several times. And it just feels like she doesn't run as well when they go longer distances with her. Maybe she'll do it in here. It's not the strongest field in the world, but, and she has a good price. I'll give her that. At the morning line odds, if you like this horse, I wouldn't argue too hard with you. I'm just not sure how good she is.
You've cashed on Ride for the Cause in the past, most notably the Grade 2 Canadian, where she was 22-1 last summer at Woodbine. And she ran just fine in the Santa Barbara last time out. Again, she got a really good trip to Saving Ground in behind the leader, came inside Neige Blanche, and just missed the bob. She is a consistent horse, Mike. And I think if you give her a trip and maybe one of these horses like Dog Tag just regresses a bit, she's got a big shot. 4-1's fair.
Yeah, she does have a big shot. I think you're right about that. 4-1 is probably a fair price on her. And I guess, again, you could just say maybe it was the mile and a half last time, Dan. Maybe it was just a little bit too far for her because you saw on the replay, just given an absolute perfect trip, came clear in the stretch, actually got a good head in front of the eventual winner there and just couldn't put the race away and got nailed on the wire. So maybe it was the distance. You know, we'll see. I feel like she's probably the other horse in here outside of Dog Tag. I just couldn't talk myself into it.
And the 8 Kuora is going to be making her first start for trainer Richard Baltus. This horse returning off about a 5.5 month layoff. But maybe her form is dirtied up a little bit, Mike, because this is the first time she's going to be allowed to stretch out in distance since she won that stakes race in Peru. Now, who knows what she was beating in Peru in 2019, but apparently she likes distance and she can be forwardly placed.
Yeah, a little bit of a wild card, I suppose, here, switching trainers here. It's the same owner, so this is just a trainer change, not a private purchase or anything. And they're just going to try something different with her here. Maybe it'll work then. I'll be honest, I really tried to like her. I went back and looked at all of her races. I just really wasn't taken with anything that she did last year. Maybe she'll improve.
Dog Tag's way the horse to beat as we take a look at our top picks for the possibly perfect stakes. I don't know. I thought maybe Catch the Eye improved a little bit last time out. I doubt she would have won with a perfect trip. I think she would have been a little bit closer if she had a chance to run when she seemed full of it at the 3/16. I'm going to use her Dog Tag, though, the horse to beat and maybe the horse to catch.
Yeah, I'm not going to argue with anybody's pick in this race. I'm not dying to bet Dog Tag at a short price in here, Dan. I just feel like maybe she's found the right field.
3756 for Mike, 6357 for me. Same super different order in the possibly perfect stakes, the co-feature at the Great Race Place on Sunday. Good luck.